Our time is short. In a few days, the Dalek forces will have penetrated our defenses. If we must act, we must do so now.
The Daleks are building a weapon. They call it the Moment. If we can steal it, we can adapt it and use it against them.
Doctor, we cannot risk any more soldiers to meet your demands. After your failure at the Gates of Elysium, due to your insistency to rescue the creator of the Daleks, it is difficult to trust you.
This is different now. Davros was a lost cause, I admit, but without him as their commander, the Daleks become more formidable.
It may interest you to know, Doctor, that we are developing a response as we speak. I'm sorry? The Ark is nearing completion, Doctor. We need but one planet core to finalize the power source.
The Ark? I thought that was decommissioned.
We continued with the production in case of a time that we greatly needed it.
Then, which planet core do we need?
He deserves to know.
Earth.
What?
The planet has the perfect core energy. We tried looking for alternatives, but no.
Earth is innocent. I will not see it being destroyed for an unjustified reason.
This is war, Doctor. Sacrifices must be made.
Earth is precious to me. As long as I live, I will defend it like I have defended this planet. I will defend it to my last breath, and if I have to, I will face an entire Time Lord Armada to keep it from harm.
So be it.
What are we to do?
Find another planet core to act as a temporary power source. If the Doctor is killed, we will continue.
And if he isn't?
Then we make sure that he is.
Are you sure? He is, after all, our greatest warrior.
Like I said to the Doctor, Counselor, sacrifices must be made.
I'm the Doctor.
Don't you ever grow tired of saving that wretched planet, Doctor? After all these years, surely it must be getting exhausting.
I know that voice. That's impossible.
Ah, you recognize me then.
How couldn't I, Master? You're dead.
And yet, are you really surprised?
Where are you?
I'm speaking through the TARDIS' psychic link. Currently, I'm in a completely different time. Meet me at these space-time coordinates. I'm so longing to meet you.
50,000 AD. What on earth are you doing there? I can't say it's a pleasure to see you.
I didn't expect it to be.
Why are you here?
I'm not.
Excuse me? Oh, really?
My Lord Doctor. Welcome home.
Rassilon? How? I saw Gallifrey burn and die. How can you all be here? Where even is here?
You are on the Ark.
The Ark?
Yes, Doctor. We finished it. The most powerful machine in the universe. We evacuated the citizens and used it to escape the time lock.
But that would mean you tore a hole in time itself.
And the Ark closed it. She's nearly ready, Doctor. The day of judgment is drawing near. There is but one planet core we need to complete the process. You know of which one I speak. Earth.
I won't let you.
You will have no choice. Soon you will watch the planet you love burn. Then from the dust of its people we shall create our new empire. Then, once you have paid for the destruction of Gallifrey with your tears, I will kill you.
No.
This is your reckoning, Doctor.
What are you doing?
Getting you out.
Who are you? And why are you helping me?
My name is Alesis, and I'll explain later.
The Doctor is escaping. I repeat, the Doctor is... We have some recruiting to do.
Hello, old friend.
You can never go too long without us, can you?
I need you again. It's time I finished what I started. The Time War ends. I haven't got much time. There's a race of beings, my own people, who are growing in strength by the minute. They mean to destroy every race, every planet, and will. The final key for them to do so is Earth, and if humanity doesn't make a stand, they will destroy everything. Humanity is the universe's last hope. Ready the fleet.
Rassilon has become twisted and corrupt. When he evacuated Gallifrey, he only took those loyal to him. I didn't find out until long after the escape, when I asked for my family. The Ark has been in hiding for centuries, allowing Rassilon's power to grow. Now his will is strong enough to have entire species obey him. This allowed him to use the silence to spy on you, Doctor.
The will of Rassilon? He's managed to enhance it?
Yes, now it takes years for the mind control to take effect, and humanity itself has not been Rassilon's main concern. Unfortunately, he has gained control over another species.
The Doctor has escaped. It is likely that he has warned humanity of our plan. I need your entire legion at my command.
I obey!
They've allied with the Daleks.
I thought the Daleks and the Time Lords were age-long enemies.
They were. The Daleks were everything we stood against. Now everything I did, every horrible decision I had to make during the Time War, it was all for nothing.
The Time Lords are no longer the race they used to be. The ones that remain are power-hungry maniacs that'll stop at nothing to achieve their goal. In my mind, the true Time Lords died along with Gallifrey.
All of us here have been told stories of you, Doctor. It seems that you've never hesitated to come to humanity's aid. Now allow us to come to yours.
Doctor? Follow me.
This was forged for the use of the Grand Commander in battle. It's made of all the rarest materials from every one of Earth's colonies. Hardest metal in the human empire.
You're giving me this? Why?
It's you who will be leading us, Doctor. We know nothing of the Time Lords. This can cut a Dalek clean in half. Can't say much for Rassilon's staff, but it's the best we have.
But this is a symbol of humanity's unity and companionship. You can't give it to an alien.
If the legends are true, Doctor, there's no one who deserves to wield it more than you.
Thank you.
No dragon this time?
The dragon died, Doctor. It was over 1,000 years old.
A millennia? How old does that make you?
Old enough.
This is it. Whatever happens in this battle, I don't know if I can continue traveling. Everything I do just makes things worse. Perhaps it's better to just stay out of the way.
I once thought that, but time changes people. Maybe what you need is just a rest.
Maybe.
Look!
The Daleks are in position, my Lord Rassilon. They await your command.
Extend the air shield. They are here.
We intercept them and meet them head on. Once a squad has got inside and disabled the shield, you will all be beamed out and we will unleash everything we have on them. Good luck.
This better work, Doctor.
Now!
So you choose to die with the humans?
A long time ago, I made a promise to defend the Earth and its people. And I will keep that promise.
So be it.
Thank you.
too many of!
Shields are down. Repeat, the shields are down.
Get everyone back on board. Now let's finish this.
Fire!
For Gallifrey.
What's going on?
Oh, I have been stupid.
What?
With no structure to keep them stabilized, the planet cores are merging. If something doesn't stabilize the explosion, it could consume galaxies.
Or is there anything that can prevent it?
Well, a black hole could consume the explosion and stabilize it, but where are we going to find... I can stop the explosion. The Eye of Harmony is a suspended black hole. I can pilot the TARDIS into the core and release it.
You'll die. No, no, Doctor. Don't do this.
Jack, you know as well as I do that I have to. And you know that I choose to. Don't stop me.
Good luck, Doctor.
So, here we are, old girl. It's been brilliant. 1,200 years on an adventure through space and time. Just what the Doctor ordered.
It is almost a crime to be one of the few people who know of this man in a universe that is almost entirely in his debt. To those...
It just occurred to me that we've never properly introduced ourselves. Captain Jack Harkness, and who are you?
Now, that would be telling. Much like the Doctor, I keep my past close to my chest.
You remind me of him. You know, I mean, slightly different dress sense and all, but... just as mysterious.
Some things are best kept a secret. My name, who I really am. They are definitely those things.
Guarding a cave for so many thousands of years, how is that possible? Didn't you ever get bored?
It made a change to my original lifestyle, but who knows? Perhaps now is a good time to continue, to see the stars again. It was good to meet you again, Jack.
I'm alive.
No, no, please, do go on staring. It'll make this whole situation a lot clearer.
Who are you? Oh. Of course.
I'm the Doctor. But that's not the least bit important. The question is, who are you? And what are you doing on my TARDIS?
I'm... the Doctor.
Oh. My future self, I presume. Thought I was over that phase.
Your future? That can't be. I don't remember being you.
So, another dimension then?
Yeah, that makes sense, I suppose.
Well, does it? Well, do it enlighten me, because I'm still finding this whole situation rather baffling.
Yeah, I flew my TARDIS into an exploding planet core engine and released the Eye of Harmony to contain the cataclysm.
Well, that was incredibly stupid. What did you do that for?
Last resort. No other way to save everyone.
I see. Ever the softy, aren't we?
Do you think I can get back?
You released a black hole from inside a TARDIS. You tore through the fabric of reality. Be thankful you're alive, let alone thinking about getting back.
Priorities, I suppose.
There's a small chance I could fire you through the tear before it closes. But I make no promises.
May I ask you a question? It's not often I get to meet myself. May as well use the opportunity.
Please.
Do you ever think it's worth it? Travelling, I mean. So many things seem to go wrong. I cause a chain reaction leading to an event that I then have to sort out. I tell someone that a planet is under my protection and they just wait it out until they have an armada at their disposal. Sometimes I think it might be better if I just... stopped.
And what about all those times when it wasn't your fault? When you stepped in regardless of the cause? Where the lives you save outnumber those that are lost? Time travel has consequences, we knew that when we left Gallifrey. But take what you just did. All those people alive, and look at you! You got out with barely a scratch. Sure, sending you back might blow you apart, but that's the excitement of it. The rush of adrenaline in the face of danger, and then the incredible feeling of being free. So yes, in answer to your previous question, it is very worth it.
Always knew I could rely on me.
You flatter yourself. So, your options are as follows. Return to your universe and risk being blown to smithereens. Or, stay in this universe and have tea.
I don't think a universe can handle two doctors. Don't you agree? I have my own dimension to explore.
Agreed.
No chance you could return my TARDIS, is there? If I came through to this universe, it should be here too.
Or do I look like Santa Claus? It'll be millennia before you can travel again. You know that.
Oh, I'll find something to do. If I survive, I'll regenerate, won't I?
If you're lucky. Say goodbye to that ginger hair of yours. I'm very jealous, by the way.
Shame. Still, perhaps it's time for a new face. Thank you.
Yeah, don't mention it, Doctor.
One day I'll go back. One day.